everyone, it's Els here on Technique Friday. Today I'll be showing you a Valentine's Day card. This is the card I'm going to create and it's an easel, so you put it in there. So it's a fun card to create and a fun fold as well to use. So that's the card, and then I have two more samples here, but I'll show you those in a second. Let me show you the dies first. So I use the stitched heart die set, the fitted heart die set, the hearts and paw prints, so that's the pattern you see here. And then this system also comes in butterflies and stars, like star spray. And then they're just for you. And I wanted to show you how I store these, because with the letters, because it's mirrored, it's always hard to see. So here on the back I wrote just for you, and I have let it snow on there as well, on the magnet. So those are the dies I'm using. And what I'm going to do first, and then I use the petal pink silk microfine glitter as well. And what I'm going to do first, I'm going to show you how I created the glittered hearts on there. So this is the heart I'm going to work on. And then I made a stencil with that die set. So I run it through, and I have a star spray here as well. And what I use for that is the alcohol ink Yupo paper from Tim Holtz, because that's very good to use to make stencils as well. So I cut that, and then I'm going to put it on here and then tape it. Kind of see where I want it to be. And of course you use removable tape. This is post-it tape that I have here. And then I tape it on the back as well to make sure it stays on there well. And of course any removable tape will work well for this technique. So make sure this is taped well. I'm going to turn it over. And then I'm going to use the paste. So what I use is the Texture Paste Transparent Gloss from Ranger. Just take a little bit, and of course you can put it back after you used it. So I just put it on there lightly, and then at the end I always give it a kind of like a hole that it's kind of is flat. So I think that looks nice. And then you can put the rest back here. Always close your jar right away so it doesn't dry. And then I'm going to remove the stencil. And that stencil I can wash off very easily. So just put it under the sink and I can clean it. So now I have my paste on here, and then I'm going to use my glitter. And what I noticed is, oh, I didn't bring my glitter tray, but I have the filter here. What I noticed is using that stencil that I actually, there is a difference in the side you're using. So you see how nice this is with the, here, picks up the glitter, beautiful. So I'm going to tap that off. And of course this needs to dry, so I made an extra one already. If I have a little bit of glitter on there, places that I don't want it, or it's sticky or whatever, you can just brush it off. But this is how it works with the paste. So the glitter picks up wonderfully on that Texture Paste Transparent Gloss. So I'm going to put this aside and bring in the one I already created. So to assemble the card. So for the back of the card, so this one, so the part that's going to be the easel part, you see I have a straight piece here, so I cut this card double. So what you do is you put your die on the cardstock, on a piece of folded cardstock, so this is a 6x6 piece here, folded cardstock, and then you put it over the edge. So you see I have a little bit piece of the die sticking out here, and then you run that through the die cutting machine, and then you have this. So this is going to be, I already put tape here, so I made a score line on one side at 2.5 inch from the top, and this is going to be my easel part. So then I have the large stitched heart here, so I'm going to take this off. That's the 1/4 inch double-sided adhesive, and I'm going to put this on that stitched, oh sorry, on the back side of course, on the stitched heart here. So you just line it up nicely. And then here now I have my base of the card. Just going to take the liner off. I already put the double-sided adhesive on there. So this is the fitted one, so that's going to fit exactly in the stitched one. So that's that. Then on the inside, I took this one, that's flat. So that's this one. So I glittered that already. And you can see I choose pink cardstock because I knew I was going to add pink glitter, so you don't have the white edge here on the side. I'm going to take that small heart and put it in the stitched one again. And then on here on the back I did foam tape because that's going to be the easel part. So I took foam dots for that. Kind of lined it up here. And then basically the easel is done, and then I'm going to add, you see, so now you have your card. And then I'm going to add the Just For You. So I cut that twice, so I'm going to layer that, and of course with the adhesive on the back. And as you see, I poked out the pieces already, because I like that better, because when you pick it up then you don't have the inside pieces sticking to your word. So that's why I always, always take out those pieces first. So I'm going to use the dark first. Should put the For You on first, so it's so. And again, you know, I always say you cannot do this without tape. This is so easy to do now. How do you glue something on like as thin as this? So it just works perfectly with the double-sided adhesive. And then I'm going to take the light pink. I'm going to layer that. I need to lean in a little bit to kind of, oh, maybe I can do it like this. No, I'm fine. So that's, and then the For You. And now it's done. And now you have your beautiful Valentine's Day card for the special person in your life. So I hope you liked it. I want to show you two more cards that Anita created. So this is with the paw prints. You see, so she made a stencil, and here she used the heart as well. So of course they're fun to use for other projects as well. So that's it for today. Thank you for watching. You can find more samples on our Facebook page, Facebook family group, Instagram and YouTube. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for the latest videos. See you next time.